Today we are going to test unknown antennas without the help of VNA, power meter or any other test equipment. This setup is for 868 MHz, but you can use it for any other frequency. It's the same. Devices used are Heltec devices, but it does not matter. You can use any other device. The process is the same. I use one device with this standard antenna, and on the other device, I will keep changing antennas under test. This is my remote device. As you can see, it is powered by a power bank, and the provided antenna is attached with this device. This device is Heltec tracker device. As I already said, it doesn't matter which device you use. We will keep this device constant. We will not change its orientation or anything else. Throughout the process, it will remain stationary at the same position. No changes. For configuration, I use Android app. This is the configuration for the fixed node or the remote node, which we will not be changing. The main configuration that I touched is the TX power. I just changed the TX power to 1 dBm. Also, we need to make sure that the both devices use the same channel and the same encryption key. In case of default channel, this encryption key is AQ equal equal. This is the configuration for the test node or test device. I name it antenna test. Just change the TX power to 1 dBm. Setup is within a building. Both devices are surrounded by walls. These devices are 100 meter apart. Purpose of placing them in the walls is to reduce the signal strength and to reduce the effect of radiation pattern. Due to walls and many other things in between, effect of radiation pattern is reduced due to reflection and refraction. If I do it in open space, that will be a totally different story. For this test, I need to make radiation pattern irrelevant or less relevant. Distance between the two nodes is 100 meters. This is just an approximation. It doesn't need to be exactly 100 meters. With the test node, we are using a 20 dB attenuator. What is an attenuator? Here is my video. Purpose of attenuator is to reduce the signal further. We have already reduced the signal through configuration. We have changed it to just 1 dBm. And now putting this attenuator will make it minus 20 dBm. We can achieve the same effect by increasing the distance between the two nodes. We can eliminate the attenuator by increasing the distance. If we don't do it, a stronger signal will distort our results. Most probably we will get wrong results. A strong signal can pass through a broken antenna, and it can pass through totally irrelevant, a different frequency antenna, which we don't want. In the first test, we are using J-pole antenna. This antenna was built in this video. We will initiate test and see the results in the Android app. I have just opened the screen where we can see other nodes. Right click on the fixed node and then click on request position. Take a reading of the RSSI and SNR. When we click on the request position, a packet is sent by the test node to the fixed node. Fixed node observes the packets and checks the signal strength and SNR. Then it creates a response packet. It may or may not send the position coordinates. In any case, it sends back the just noted RSSI, which is received signal strength and signal to noise ratio. As soon as our test node receives this packet from fixed node, it displays it here. If you want to know more about SNR, here is my video. Let's go ahead with the second test. This is a large, big antenna. sending request position, and we got -101. So this antenna is okay. Next is the second antenna of the same type. To differentiate, I have tilted it to 90 degree angle, and this is great. It gives -86 with 4.5 SNR. So both antennas coming in the same order from the same company are behaving differently. They have different performance, simply the bad company. This is a log periodic antenna. It doesn't work. See the 2-minute mark. That means it is not updated recently. Let's move ahead to fifth test, selecting connectors and just sent the request. Nothing. No, it doesn't work. Let's go to the sixth test. It is an ABRI antenna. No, it doesn't work. Go for seventh test. Send the request for position. No answer is coming. Let's see the eighth test. It's not working. This is another log periodic antenna, but it doesn't work as well. Next is the uniden antenna. Great, it's great. -89 with a 4.5 SNR. That is very nice. This antenna is coming from this scanner, so it's performing great. See you again on another video.